This video is about multiparty computation. Multiparty computation is a subarea in cryptography, which considers a general setup of any number of parties who do not necessarily trust each other. The goal in multiparty computation is to come up with a scheme that allows the parties to compute a function, f, securely, without revealing their inputs. There are many different problems studied in multiparty computation. Let us start with secret sharing. What is secret sharing? Say you have a safe that only a secret key can open. How can a board of directors share a key such that only if they all agree, they can open the safe? The main idea is to have a slightly different safe with many locks where each lock has a different key. Then we can distribute the keys to the directors, and only if they all agree, the safe can be opened. How can we do this in a digital world? One way of doing it is by using XOR. Given a key, you can write it as XOR of five other keys, as shown in this equation. The circle notation here represents the XOR operation. All keys are chosen uniformly at random, where one of the keys, for example, K5, is chosen suitably so that the XOR of all of them results exactly to K. One can easily show that if you have any four of the keys, you have no chance of finding the key K, even if you are computationally unbounded. This simple scheme is perfectly secure, but we can only reconstruct the original key if all the keys are present. However, a key may get lost, and it might be better if a majority of directors can also open the safe. This is where threshold secret sharing can be used. Here, a threshold T can be any value, not necessarily a majority. So, how does threshold secret sharing work? The main idea comes from polynomial interpolation. We start by choosing a random polynomial of degree t-1. From calculus, we know that such a polynomial is uniquely identified by t values. Or in other words, it can be reconstructed if we have any t evaluation point of the polynomial. Such a reconstruction can be done, for example, using Newtonian interpolation. Once we have the random polynomial, we shift the polynomial such that the evaluation value at zero is our secret value. Here, for example, the secret value is 2. To share the secret, first, every director has a public number, such as 1, 2, 3, and so on. Each director gets a share, P of I. In this example, we have 6 directors. Let us assume the threshold T is 4 and the polynomial is of degree 3. If any 4 of the directors come together and exchange their shares, then they can uniquely reconstruct the polynomial and get the secret by evaluating the polynomial at value 0. However, if only 3 of them meet, they cannot reconstruct the same polynomial and thus also not the secret. This method works only if directors are honest. If one of the directors is malicious, depending on how the protocol is defined, the director might be able to cheat. The malicious director can change its value and make the other directors reconstruct an incorrect secret. There are more advanced methods that can catch malicious behavior. Additionally, for simplicity, we used real numbers, however in cryptography typically only discrete numbers are used. This is done by doing the operations modulo a prime number. Our method can be used also in such a modulo setup. Let us look at another example. Say the board of directors wants to compute the average salary, but no director is willing to tell their salary. How can they compute the average? Take a minute to think about potential ideas. The algorithm works as follows. The first director chooses a large random number and adds their salary S1. Then the first director sends this sum, M1, to the second director. The second director sees the sum. Without knowing the random value, the second director cannot know the salary of the first director. This is perfectly secure. The second director takes the sum, adds their own salary, and privately sends the sum to third director. And so on. Finally, the fifth director adds their salary and sends the sum back to the first director. Now the first director simply subtracts the initial random number and divides by 5 to compute the average salary. The director can then share this result with all directors. Now every director knows the average, but none of them know the salary of the other directors. Note that this protocol assumes that all directors follow the protocol, and they do not misbehave. There are more general protocols that allow to compute general functions, even if some of the parties cheat. Let us summarize what we learned in this video. We presented multiparty computation, where we consider any number of parties who do not necessarily trust each other. Each party has a private input. Together they want to compute a function f, without revealing their inputs. We have seen two examples. The first example was threshold secret sharing, that allows the parties to share a secret, such that any large enough subset can reconstruct the secret. In the second example, we have seen how we can compute an average without revealing any input. Thank you for watching this video.